water can flow through soil, and we would like to know how fast it actually flows through the soil. For sandy material, water can flow very quick. For clay, it can flow very slowly. To find out how fast water flows in the soil, we can do two different tests. The first test that we will do today is a constant head test, which is shown here, the setup. We do this test for sand, for sandy material, in which water flows very quickly. As you can see here, water flows through the soil. To do this test, we need to have a mold. We fill this mold with the soil. We prepare this soil for a few days to make sure that the soil is saturated and there is a constant and a steady water flow through the soil. The water comes to the top of the sample, that it travels all the way down and it comes out here. There are three entries in this mold, here on the top, in the middle, and one on the bottom. They're connected to the stand pipes, which you will see on the wall. In the stand pipes, you will see water level. This is actual water level that we measure at these three points of manometers, top, middle, and bottom. The difference, the distance between the top and the middle manometer is 7.5 centimeters, the same distance from the middle to the bottom. For this test, we use a water tank on the top to keep the water level constant through the whole test. We also use three sets of manometers. These stand pipes are attached to the wall, and they are connected to the sample at three different levels, to the top of the sample, middle, and the bottom of the sample. During each test, we need to measure the water level or head of water in these manometers. And the one on the left-hand side, which is connected to the top part of the sample, would give us numbers of 1,411 millimeters. The one in the middle will give number of 1,328 millimeters. And the manometer on the right-hand side has a number of 1,252 millimeters. So these are water levels, water heads, that are now acting in the soil sample during the test. When water flows through the sample and it's under a constant flow, we will see that when we measure water levels at these three manometers, they will be the same. They will be constant. That's why this test is called a constant head test. What we will do now is we would like to know how much water comes out of the soil over time, so that we can calculate the velocity of water flow. Once we know the velocity of water flow, we can calculate the coefficient of permeability, which is very important property of soil that we would like to get from this test. To do this test, we will use this water container that can measure the amount of water, and we will use a timer. The test is pretty simple. We would like to know how much water flows in this container over a certain period of time. And this is what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to start the timer and collect water at the same time. It takes 43 seconds to collect 92 milliliters of water. We should repeat this test a few more times to get an average value. And then after we do the calculations, we'll get the coefficient of permeability of this test. We need to repeat this test at least 5 times with a different water flow. This is going to be our second test. We increase the water flow. When we change the water flow, we also change the level of water in manometers. Now we'll start collecting water and timing it. It took 30 seconds to collect 90 milliliters of water for this test. Now I will check the water head in the manometers. To get accurate readings, we need to use the ladder, this one. The reading on the left-hand side in the manometer is 1,324 millimeters. The manometer in the middle gives the reading of 1,206 millimeters, and the manometer on the right-hand side, which is connected to the bottom part of the sample, gives a reading of 1,096 millimeters.